It's time now to clear the air, and there seems to be something of a pattern developing around President Obama's administration. Each week we have gridlock in Washington, and on Tuesday the Senate failed to pass a modified version of the president's jobs bill. Yet on the very same day, the Attorney General announced the successful disruption of an Iranian plot to murder the Saudi Arabian ambassador. And the president was absolutely clear that this was a serious act of terror.
We also know that he had direct links, was paid by and directed by individuals in the Iranian government.
But it was thwarted, and it was just the latest in a series of foreign policy successes. Just look at the president's kill list this year. At the top of that list, the death of Osama bin Laden, quickly followed by a drone strike that ended the life of Anwar al-Awlaki, who was the head of al-Qaeda in the Arabian Peninsula. And it's worth remembering that bin Laden was taken out just as Congress was getting stuck in its gridlock over raising the debt ceiling. Again, an outstanding foreign policy success, the most wanted man in the world taken out, at the same time a domestic agenda that stalls. You see, for all the abject nonsense that Michelle Bachmann spouts about Barack Obama being a weak leader, this is a president who does lead when he's allowed to lead. Imagine what this country might look like if the debt ceiling debacle had not taken place and if the president's jobs bill was allowed to pass. According to one independent assessment, that bill would create 2 million new jobs and increase growth by no less than 2%. But sadly, that ain't going to happen. And the pattern of President Obama's apparent failure at home and success overseas is probably going to continue until the election next year.